So in the last session, we have discussed about so different generators, that is pulse and square wave generators. So we discussed about the pulse and square generators. So from there we can produce the square wave with a duty cycle of 50%. So that duty cycle, by changing the duty cycle, we can get the desired pulse output waveform. So, and we can also discuss about the operation of the pulse generator. So how it will be produce the output waveforms by using schematic trigger and capacitor. And similarly, we can also discuss about the generation of the noise, random noise. Generation of random noise, so white noise, pink noise, and usasi noise. So different noise signals are generated. So it is shown with one of the example by using Zener diode. So it is a pink noise, and the frequency bands of pink, white, and usasi noises are shown in this graph sheet. And coming to next one, so the sweep generator. Sweep generator. What is the sweep? First of all, we have to know. So what is the sweep generator? What is the use of sweep generator? And what are the applications of sweep generator? We'll see. So students, are you getting clear picture of this one? I think you are getting the clear visibility. So sweep generators. So sweep generators are also called as time-based generators. And the sweep generators will produce linear output voltage or linear output current with respect to time. So they will produce the, with respect to time, they produce the output voltage and currents. That's why you can call them as a time-based generators. Time-based generators. So generally, we can use in CROs, to sweep the electron beam from left to right. So in the horizontal deflectional plates of the CRO, we will apply the sweep generator output voltage to the electrodes of horizontal deflectional plates. And by that, the electron beam of the CRO will be deflects from left to right. So it is one of the application of a sweep generator. And the next one is the linear current waveform is applied to deflection plates of the TV receiver. For TV receiver also, we apply the the linear current waveform to deflect the plates. So these are the main two important applications of sweep generator. So all of you know that this is the time and this is the voltage. Okay, and sweep waveform you can also observe. So it is initially it is from 0 to it is changing linearly up to certain value. You can say it is a so Vm. And after that, the waveform is coming after reaching the maximum value, it reaches to the minimum value. So it will reach the minimum value. It is okay. And the time period to reach the linear waveform, linear output up to that particular point, the time taken. To reach this particular the voltage, the linear voltage. So this one is known as sweep time. Okay. So that is Ts. You can write as Ts. And after reaching the maximum value, the output voltage will be decreases. Okay. So and this particular time to reach the minimum value of the voltage. So this particular amount of time that is known as restoration time. Nothing but so restoration time that is TR. Okay, and after that again the it will produces the linear voltage and again the voltage will be decreased to minimum value. So like that the sweep output voltage will be generated. So for that we have a total time period. Time t is equals to sum of the sweep time and restoration time. Sweep time plus restoration time, TR. Okay. So with this time period, the output waveform of the sweep generator will be produces. Okay. So generally, this sweep time is more than the restoration time. Okay. And coming to the basic law diagram of sweep generator. So the main elements present in the law diagram of the sweep generators are the RF mass translator and amplifier. RF mass translator and amplifier and frequency sweeper frequency sweeper, marker generator, level control circuit, and manual frequency control, range switch. So this range switch is available at the front panel of the instrument. Range switch is available at the front panel of the instrument. And we can have a level control circuit. Level control circuit, we can adjust the level of the sweep signal. So we can change the in what level, what is the level of the output voltage. So that will be also, we can adjust. So using the output control knob will be provided at the front panel of the instrument. So by using output control knob, we can adjust the level of this sweep voltage, a sweep waveform. And we can also measure using output voltage. We can also measure the output waveform. The voltage we can get in the meter. Okay, and similarly we have output attenuators. So with this we can have all the ranges of the range of frequency ranges. So from that we can select the desired frequency range, and that will be considered as an RF output. It is a sweep output voltage. Okay. So mainly it provides a sinusoidal output voltage whose frequency varies smoothly and continuously over the frequency band of order range. We can produce the sinusoidal voltage, and that voltage frequency we can vary. Voltage, output voltage and frequency we can change according to our desired voltage and frequency. And here the modulation will be occurred, frequency modulation will be done by two methods. So that is electronically and mechanically. So by the, here we have a frequency sweeper is there. So by this frequency sweeper, so there is a variation of the masked oscillator output will be occurs. Frequency sweeper provides variable modulating voltage, which causes the capacitance of the masked oscillator is varies. So frequency sweeper will use the modulating voltage. So that modulating voltage may be changes. We can change different modulating voltages we can apply. Okay, and due to that, the capacitance of the masked oscillator is also changes, and according to that, it will produce the sweep voltage. So, and the generated frequency sweep voltage is also applies to the as a display for the horizontal sweep voltage in the CRO. And the process of frequency modulation is done by electronically and mechanically. So electronically, how it means, there is a by varying the reactance of the oscillator of tank circuit component. So generally, you can say oscillator is a nothing but tank circuit. So in that we can change the L and C. So most of the cases is possible to change easily with the capacitor. So the value of the capacitance changes, then the frequency of the generated oscillator will be changes. So, but inductor in the tank circuit, we have L inductor and capacitor. So why you don't change the inductor means changing of the inductor value is difficult. So the inductance value will be changes depends upon the number of turns of the coil, magnetic core. Okay. And mutual inductance, suppose it is usually in mutual inductance, so self inductance, all these factors will be effects. So changing of all these factors is difficult. So but change of the capacitance is easy and easy. Okay, so that's why most of the cases we can change the value of capacitance in the tank circuit of L and C, combination of L and C. So capacitance value will be changes by adjusting the plates, the plates of the capacitor. So we can change the distance, and we can change the overlapping area like that. So by that we can vary the capacitance, and due to that, so there is a change in the oscillator's frequency. And similarly, we can also change by using mechanically. So that is by means of motor-driven capacitor. So the capacitor is connected to a motor. So by applying the supply to the motor, so depending upon the amount of the voltage applied to that motor, so it will be rotates, and according to that, the one of the plates of the capacitor will be changes. That change in capacitance will be observed by running with the motor. Okay. So this is by the mechanical variation of the capacitor, and electronically is the we can change the reactance of the oscillator. Okay. So like this, we can change the frequency of the RF oscillator. Okay. So the frequency shaper provides the variable modulating voltage. Variable modulating voltage. So it causes the capacitance of the master oscillator to vary. So in the master oscillator, the capacitance also changes with the frequency shaper. By the frequency modulation process, we can generate the oscillations. So sweep rate can be produced in the order of 20 sweeps per second. So it will produces a voltage that is 20 sweeps per second. Within 1 second, seconds of time, so it generates the 20 sweeps. Okay. 20 sweeps. And manual control. Here we have manual control. Manual frequency control. So there is a chance to adjust the frequency by manually. So we can adjust the frequency by manually. And manual control allows independent adjustment of the resonant frequency of the oscillator. The frequency sweeper also provides a varying sweep voltage for synchronization to drive the horizontal plates of the CRO. So at the other end of the frequency sweeper, so we can So it provides a sweep voltage, varying sweep voltage for synchronization to drive the horizontal plates. So to drive the horizontal plates of the CRO. Okay. And the amplitude of the response of the test device will be logged and displayed on the screen. So with this synchronization process, so the amplitude of the response of the test device will be logged and displayed on the screen. So we can hold the response of the circuit. Suppose we are testing the response of any circuitry. So that response we have to hold, or we can lock it. Okay. And it can be possible to display on the screen. To identify the frequency interval, marker generator. So there is a marker generator is there. So it is a marker generator. This marker generator provides the option to identify the time. So it provides the options to so we can identify the time period. So it provides the half of the sine wave signal. To identify the frequency interval, so marker generator provides the half sinusoidal waveforms. at any frequency within the sweep range. So within the sweep range and at any frequency, we can identify the frequency interval using marker generator. So, and we have another circuit, that is automatic level control circuit. So automatic level control circuit is a closed loop feedback system, so which monitors RF level at some point in the measurement system. So it will maintain the, so here the automatic control system is a feedback system. So from the, from the output of the RF mass oscillator, so it collects the signal, and from there it will take the feedback from the RF mass oscillator, and from that it will be monitors the RF level. So at what level of the radio frequency signals are generating, so that will be monitored by using the level control circuit. And also it holds the power delivered to the load. It also holds the power delivered to the load or test circuit constant, and independent of frequency and impedance changes. So how much power is delivered to the load? So it also holds the power delivered to the load or the test circuit. Okay. And so, and it's and it is power, and it's and the circuit is independent of the frequency and impedance changes. So irrespective of the frequency and impedance changes, this automatic level control circuit will be works. And it also provides constant power level, which prevents any source mismatch, and also provides a constant readout calibration with frequency. So a constant power level, it the automatic level control circuit provides constant power level, and it prevents any source mismatch, and also provides a constant readout calibration with frequency. It also provides the calibration process. By that calibration, we can get the proper output. We can check whether whether it is producing proper output or not. So by that we can have the level control circuit. So like this, we have the generators, signal generators. So audio frequency range, signal generators, square wave pulse, square wave and pulse generators, standard audio frequency generators, sweep generators, and noise, random noise signal generators. So in the generator section, so we have these are the generators. So in the coming classes, we will see. So what are the analyzers? So wave analyzers. How we can analyze the obtained waveforms? The generators will generate the waveforms, and from that waveform, we have to analyze how the waveforms are producing properly or not. So suppose we want to check the signal at a particular frequency. We have to check the frequency at particular frequency. What is the voltage? And selective frequencies we can observe. So how the whether it is producing proper output or not. So like that, we can use the wave analyzers. So in the range of audio frequency and the radio frequency range, we have wave analyzers, and also we have distortion analyzers. So distortion signals. So when we apply the input signal to a particular circuit, so the output may be distorted. So by applying the sinusoidal signal, so the output it will be changes, and distorted signals will be generated, and those distortion components will be measured by using distortion analyzers. So those wave analyzers and the distortion analyzers we will see in the next session. So we will see in the next class. So with this, I am ending the class. So if you have any doubts up to now, you can ask me. So actually, this particular subject is relates to so how the signals are sending to different sections of the instruments. So generally, the electronics measurements and instrumentation. So the entire instrument will be divided into blocks. So each section will be divided into blocks. So in this, we will study. So how the signals are moving from one section to another section. So what is the input? So what type of the signal it is producing, or what type of the signals it is analyzing. So like that, we will be explained. So the input is applied by applying the input applying. So the input voltage is where it is going, and from there, so how it is analyzing. So how it is mixing with some other circuits, or process modulation process is going on. So in this, we are not study in depth how the inside process is occurring. So in the electronic measurement instrument EMI circuit, so we will see. So from where to where the signal is going on, and what is the final output. So especially for coming to signal generators and wave analyzers and distortion analyzers, so we will observe. So what are the major components are present inside. So that major components will be represented as a block diagram. So in that block diagram, it will be having the functionalities of the each component. So but we are not bothered about the what are the major components are present. Suppose you can see a modulator, a schemi trigger. Suppose you can see schemi trigger. So this schemi trigger circuit we already studied in previous semesters. So by using op amp we can construct this schemi trigger. So but we are not bothered about how it will be generated, the schemi trigger, how much voltage it is generating, and those are not included in this subject. So finally, what is the process, how the process is the generating process is going on. So that we will see. So in different sections we can explain the output of the schemi trigger is applied to switching circuit. Like that you can explain. First of all, you have to learn the block diagram. So first you draw the block diagram, and from that we can from the block diagram only we can explain what is the main functionality of each component or each block. So what is the major role of each block, and that can explained in the examination also. Okay, because all these we don't go in depth of each block. Suppose you say that upper current source. So what are the current sources are there? So that we can't see here. So the main thing I want to say is we have to understand the how the signals are generating and what are the major sections are presenting in a given instrument. So instrument and major things. These are main considerations. I think you can understand what I'm saying. So now in this subject we have more number of block diagrams. So don't be confused with that, and you have to clear differentiation between one to other. In the final exam, you may get confusion. So most people will confuse. So which block, which diagram, which for the correspond which answer. So it's better to practice the block diagrams. And if you know the block diagram clearly, and from that you can write in your own narration. Okay. So this is what I want to say. Anybody have any clarifications or anything? You can type in chat. No problem. I will see. The main purpose of chat here, chat in the Zoom app is, so if you have any doubts, so that should be clarified through chat only. So you can type. You can type in chat. So from that I can understand whether you people are understanding or are listening or something. So what is this number 44? What is this? No, sir. Sorry. So if any difficulty, you can call, you can what is this no sir means for 44? Who is 44? Okay. So with this I am closing this session. If you have any clarifications or doubts, you can type in the chat. Okay. Thank you.